Welcome to the Family First Retirement Podcast with George Politaris. For more information on the Patrea Wealth Group or to schedule your complimentary consultation, visit PatreaWealth.com. Now, let's get to the show.
You know, George, every week we say here on Family First Retirement that there are no questions too big or too small when it comes to your retirement. And I heard one that, to be honest, it surprised me, but it makes a lot of sense. They were asking for guidance when making retirement withdrawals. That's a great question. How do you help?
It is a great question, Mark, because people just sit and make an assumption, oh, I just do what I'm allowed to do. And it's really about the foresight to see what we're trying to take care of for down the road as we get older. Because we always say we have good news and we have bad news. Mm-hmm. Good news for you, Mark, is you're living longer. Yes. Woo, balloons popping. Yay. Bad news is you're living longer. So there used to be a rule that you could take up to 4% out of your retirement accounts and be fine. Then it gets a little bit lower, about 2% of the cash value. But when we sit down, we're going to look at what our objective with our funds are. Why are we doing this? Is it because I'm allowed to take 10% per se, so why not take it? Just because you're allowed something, Mark, you don't necessarily do it. Mm-hmm. You're allowed to eat three, you know, tasty cakes. Do you want to eat all three? You do, but you shouldn't.
There's a difference between a want and a need.
Exactly. So when we sit down, we're going to go over that with you and educate you, because it's important to have an education and to see what our agenda is, how we're going to obtain it, and make sure we're in a better place tomorrow. Because at the end of the day, we're always planning for the next day.
And as we said, there are no questions too big or too small to George and the team at the Patrea Wealth Group. So if you hear anything this weekend you need some clarity on, or you're going, you know what, I'm in that situation, I can use some guidance, 302-330-2166. That initial consultation, it's no cost, it's no obligation. And of course, always online at PatreaWealth.com. And something else that I know you're getting a lot of questions on is Social Security.
Oh, yes.
A new Mercer study graded retirement systems around the world. And it says that the U.S. deserves no higher than a C+. One of the biggest reasons is this looming solvency crisis, which is projected to hit as early as 2033. So, George, how are you helping clients plan around this for the future so their retirement doesn't get hit with a failing grade?
It's really a scary situation for a lot of people right now. And one of the things that's a blessing when you work with myself and my team here at Patrea Wealth Group is we have proprietary programs that are looking at the possibility of you being someone that is going to be penalized in 2033. And what's that mean, Mark? Well, let's say that you turn on Social Security in 2030 and you're getting $1,000 a month. Great. In 2033, what is the probability that your pension, your Social Security annuity, because that's what Social Security is an annuity, will be reduced by up to 24%.
Pretty big right now.
It is. It's really big. And we need the plan for that. I think that's so why it's so important that when you speak to myself and our team, that you need to have a financial plan put in place. And that means more than just having a spreadsheet, folks. Because you meet a lot of people and they come in and they say, well, I already have a financial plan, George. I'm like, that's great. What's it look like? It's nothing more than an Excel spreadsheet, which is not a bad way to start. But it's not something that you can really focus on for your future. So when they come in, we're going to go over a complete financial plan. It starts with an income plan. So you're making your salary right now, where your money is coming from, the assets we have put aside for retirement, your 401k, your 403b, your TSP for federal employees, 457 IRA, CD, savings, all those things. Because we want to see today you're making it from here, but tomorrow when you retire, where's it going to come from? Where, if you have a pension, great. When's that start? How about Social Security for you and your spouse? When's the right opportunity? And that's part of the Social Security plan, which we use to make sure we see that. We're going to go over expenses with you. We're going to plan for the things that you're going to be doing in the future, in 10 years. When you start traveling more that you do now, we're going to plan for that too. And we're going to go over a nasty word called taxes. So we plan for all these things. And with the Social Security, Mark, what I do now is we show Social Security starting, and then 2033, I'm taking a bold step, I guess, by using these plans, and I'm showing the reduction occurring for my customers in 2033. And you may ask, George, why would you show something you don't know to be true yet? Mm-hmm. And the reason is you need the plan for worst case scenarios. Because what happens, Mark, if I get there and the government turns around in all its wisdom, they work together like they're supposed to work for us, and they fix this situation, and there is no reduction.
Well, that's just a bonus for me.
Absolutely. You're in a much better place. But if they stay along the lines they're currently in, and it does get reduced, I'm mad, but I am still okay because we planned for the worst case scenario, and that's what makes it so important.
302-330-2166. Again, 302-330-2166. Now, Cody Sanchez is a portfolio manager who is also a podcaster. And George, you said that Jared, who works at the Betrayal Wealth Group, your son, he's a fan of Cody.
I have no idea who she is.
But
he's
just
like dead. I'm like, ah.
But Cody is respected across the industry. And Cody appreciates creative income streams and has an admiration for actress and producer Reese Witherspoon. This is from her podcast.
Reese Witherspoon basically took a book club and said to authors, I'll give you part of my platform for you to talk about your book because I'm lovely. It's free. You're going to sell a bunch of books. Tiny insignificant detail. I'd like the future rights to turn your book into a movie and I'll pay you some sum, or I'll have a right of first refusal, aka I get the right to buy it before anybody else and I'll pay you then for it. The author goes, amazing. Reese, of course. Perfect. They come on. Reese basically tests out which books do best. And depending on which books do best, Reese buys their movie rights and makes movies that create, you know, tens of millions or hundreds of millions of dollars in revenue.
George, it's amazing. When I think of Hollywood actress Reese Witherspoon, she's adorable, worth millions and millions of dollars. I think she's been nominated for a couple of Oscars. I also think of George Palitaris.
You have a warped mind, my little friend.
What were you talking about, wonky? I have a wonky mind, if that's where I go. And here's why. Because what Reese Witherspoon is doing is giving opportunities to create an income stream for young artists just trying to get their name out there. George, you do the exact same thing for the families that you serve, but you help them build income through an annuity. We've talked about it before here, George. Tell me how it works.
You're absolutely right about that, because when we sit down, I feel the need to make sure that we have 3, 4, or even 5 reliable, dependable, and sustainable avenues of income for my family, my customers, in retirement. And how are we going to obtain them? Well, we just talked about Social Security. Social Security is going to be one of them, but is it going to be stable? I'm not sure about that, but at least we'll have something, God willing. Maybe you're lucky enough to have a pension. You're a federal employee. You're a school teacher. You have a pension coming in, which is another big plus. We like the pensions. But the money left over, your 401k, your TSP, you need to have a safety net. You need to have something that can never run out of money, continuously income stream for you, that's guaranteed for you and your spouse's lives. So that's where the annuity comes in. But Mark, one of the things we have to make sure we understand is not everything should be in an annuity and those funds. We still need money to get bigger and to be involved in the market, but to have it managed so that you're looking out for your best interests. Because I still need to get bigger and stronger in retirement. So when the market rises with the managed funds we're talking about, that's where we're going to pull the money out of. That's part of the plan that we get for you. Where are you going to pull the money? We talked earlier about how many people come, and it's a silly question we said about where do I take the money? How much do I take out of my funds? The bigger question is which funds or where do I take my money out of? And that's what we look at. So when your managed money is going up, well, you'd pull money out of your managed account, right? It's going up. It's getting bigger. But when that market drops, have you seen the markets lately, the stock market? It's been pretty brutal this year. Would you pull money out of a dropping market, Mark?
No.
Of course not. It's called a double dip. You're losing twice. That's where my annuity kicks in. And I start to pull income out of my annuity to cover my needs. That's my safety net. And that's what you have to remember, that an annuity fits into our retirement. You need to know how that annuity is going to prioritize your family's financial well-being going forward. How are we going to have the ability to fill a void with Social Security, fill a void when our stocks are going down, and to give us the prosperous life that you work so hard for? But it all starts with either going to Patria Wealth, P-A-T-R-I-A, wealth.com, or give us a call at 302-330-2166 and schedule that appointment to come in, sit down, and let's start the planning process. You know, there's a lot of people that go on YouTube and watch a DIY about how to change the oil in your car, Mark. But this is not a DIY, folks. This is not something you sit and just plan and just say, how hard can it be?
Right.
the customers down the street that heard the show, they came in, and they're a great couple, and he's been doing a great job of managing his retirement. But he realized that he can't afford to do it because he sees something. By the time he reacts on it, it's over. Mm-hmm. His impulsivity comes in. You need someone that's not going to be impulsive, that has a course of action, that's almost like your GPS in your car. We have a course, we have a plan, we're moving forward, we know where we're going to go, how we want to get there, and when we want to get there. And we work to accomplish what you want. That's what it's like when you work with Betrayal Wealth. We're your GPS for your financial future, helping you get to where you want to go, taking the gray out of your retirement, folks, because it's confusing as bejeebers, and making it black and white so you understand it and you can feel comfortable in the choices you're making.
302-330-2166. You're talking about the DIY plan that some adults take when putting a retirement together. Now, every week here on Family First Retirement, we talk about the complimentary portfolio x-ray. But George, that also includes a second opinion. Tell me about the importance of getting a second opinion and why you offer one at no cost.
I always believe that when you do something, Mark, there has to be a reason why you do something or make a change. When you work with these big box advisors, or even some of these little firms that you walk in the first time, you shake their hand. Hi, I'm Dan. Nice to meet you. You're Judy. How are you? And right away they say, this is what you need to do. I have a great idea for you. First off, that's a mistake. Because how in the heck does he or she know what you need without having a plan in place to evaluate your desires? Mm-hmm. When you go to a big box firm and it starts with an F or it starts with one of those big companies, they come in and say, oh, nice to meet you, Mark. They're going to let you talk to someone. And he's going to say, you're 55 years old. Great. This is where you want to be. This is the plan. Have a nice day. You are a cookie cutter. You are just like the Joneses and the Smiths after you because of your age. I hate to tell you this, but you are not a cookie cutter because each and every one of us, Mark, are unique, special people and couples. The plan should fit what your needs are, your wants, and your desires, not what they're telling you they are. I love gardening, and I love spending time with my sons, Alex and Jared, Anna, and our new grandbaby, Archie. I love that. That's me. You might want to play golf every day and travel the world. We're different. We're still good people, but we have different desires and dreams. I need my retirement plan to work for me and my family, and you need it to fit into what your family is doing. When you come in here, we're going to make it work for you. We're going to plan for the things that you don't want to talk about, because at the end of the day, I care about your family.
302-330-2166. And of course, you can always get more information at betrayalwealth.com. George, there was a couple from Texas that got hit with a $231 speeding ticket just 26 days before their wedding day. So what was their solution? They included the cost of the ticket in their donate to us section of their online wedding registry.
What the hell does that mean? Donate to us section.
You haven't seen those?
No.
You go to the knot.com or wherever they have it, and it's like, we're looking for new china and some new plates. But up in the corner, it just says, make a donation here. I think it's brilliant.
Isn't that what I write a check for when I come to the wedding?
Yeah, that's instead of
buying. So what the hell are you putting it on there for?
One less step. You know, George, you're writing
good
checks.
God.
Listen.
Yes, I do write checks. You're right. I do write checks.
Nothing wrong with that. I was about to, because I do the same thing. But let's be honest. Anybody under the age of about 35, you write them a check and they go, what do I do?
They're idiots. Jesus Christmas.
I don't know what to do with it. So, I'm sorry. To pay for that $231 speeding ticket, they said, hey, just donate to us. That creative. I'll give them credit. Creative way to cover an unexpected expense. George, for you and the families that you serve, you help them cover those unexpected costs in retirement. Let's talk about some other ways you can help with these speed bumps without having to go to the family and pretty much say, can you please donate to us?
Well, this is all foreign to me, that donate to us crap, I'll be honest with you.
Really?
I can't do Venmo. What do they call that? Venmo?
Venmo,
you send money
PayPal
to people?
And
I don't have any clue. That's what Les does. She's like, just Venmo. She handles it. I have no clue about this stuff. Anyway.
Ask Jared, ask Achilles. They'll get you all set up.
Oh, they'll just roll their eyes at me. But when we sit there and we talk about that plan we do, Mark, about how we go over income, we go over expenses, we talk about your Social Security, we go about taxes. We also plan this for the things that you're going to do in the future. And we talk about expenses. Let's think about that for a second. you sit there and say, my expenses right now, we break it down in depth for you and make you think, which is something different, but we make you think about your expenses. But I'm really thinking about in 5 or 10 years, some of the expenses we have now are going to go away. And some of the ones we don't have now, we need to replace. So one of the biggest things I talk about is we have to plan for Medicare and long-term care. How are we going to fund your expenses for as we get older, our Medicare, our supplements, our Medicare advantages? How are we going to supplement? How are we going to plan for them? So we put into that. How about long-term care? We plan for that. Even if you don't need it, we're going to plan for it because I want to make sure that if the untimely event happens that you do need it, it's scheduled. Mm-hmm. We have it covered already. And if we don't need it, well, we have some bonus money. But all about those things, about taxes. I have customers that sit there and they tell you, I want a new car every 5 years. Great. I love it. We plan for it. Just like vacations. There's no problem with these unexpected costs coming up. So we always have a discretionary expense. And the discretionary expense that I plan for are these type of things. And you may say, well, you know, additional $300 a month. I'm a firm believer that I overvalue my expenses. So I make my expenses higher and I plan on my income being lower because I always want to have the worst case scenario planned for. So in that discretionary fund, we're going to plan for an extra $500 or $600 a month if you say $200, $250. For these type of speeding tickets you're going to get through life and the speed bumps that are going to occur, there's nothing we can't handle if we line up and set up our retirement to be a smart, intelligent, fit to your needs, wants, and desires. But that starts just by coming into the office, stopping here at 501 Silverside Road, Suite 31 in Wilmington. We're right down the road from the radio station. Or give us a call, 302-330-2166. And let's schedule that because you really need the plan for the worst case scenario. What do you call me, Mark?
Grim Reaper.
Mm-hmm. And I was going to get dressed up for Halloween last week, and I decided I didn't want to change my character because I'm already the Grim Reaper accordingly, apparently. But this is what we plan for. I mean, make sure that you have no surprises, but it starts with coming in and starting the first day.
Investment advisory services are offered only through properly registered representatives of Impact Partnership Wealth, LLC, which is not affiliated with Betrayal Wealth Group. Financial professionals are not licensed in all 50 states. To find out if George Politaris is licensed in your state, please contact his office. George A. Politaris is not affiliated with nor endorsed by the Social Security Administration or any other government agency and does not provide legal or tax advice. Please consult with your attorney, accountant, and or tax advisor for advice concerning your particular circumstances. Annuity guarantees rely on the financial strength and claims paying ability of the issuing insurance company. Read your contract for restrictions, limitations, or penalties. By contacting us, you may be provided with information about insurance products, including annuities, offered through George A. Politaris. And PN number 17500473.